Don't be a dick. Be manipulative. And sometimes you should just do it for the memory. Why not? A couple weeks ago, I was in Chicago, Illinois, at a bar called Monk's. I don't expect any of you to know what that bar is. You have a drinking problem like I do. I'll break it down for the people who don't know, okay? This is what Monk's is. Monk's is this old, old English bar from like the mid-60s. It's in the financial district of Chicago, right under the L, in the loop, right? It feels like a Harry Potter themed bar that was designed for DMV workers to do coke in the bathroom. They got butter beer and bumps every day from 5 to 7. And I'm in this bar and it's completely packed, right? Sitting there minding my own, having an afternoon drink, as any boy from Rochelle, Illinois would. And all of a sudden, I hear a door get kicked open. You know that sound, right? And all of a sudden, a Midwestern god comes through that threshold. And what do I mean by that? I'm going to tell you. This guy walks through. He just takes his hand and pushes his sweat around like you do in the middle of August in Chicago, where you can't tell if it's raining or you have too much gel going, right? He's wearing straight, like, balloon brown pants, the kind your Uncle Laverne was buried in. More pleats than pockets. He's got a blazer on that I assume used to be blue. It's definitely older than I am. And he's wearing a button-up white shirt with a 15.5-inch collar, but by God, he was born with an 18-inch neck. And he just starts walking, where can I sit? Where can I sit? Where can I sit? Now remember, I am not a dick. I am manipulative. So I got out of my seat and I said, you can sit right here. I appreciate that, my man. I go, not as much as I appreciate you coming into my life. Hey, bartender, I'll tell you this right now. Can I get 3 tall draft schlitz? Give me a big old glass of water. And don't worry about the order. I pound them in. Sorry, man, we don't have schlitz on draft. I don't care. Make them cans and keep them coming until I fall down or walk out. How's it going, buddy? I said, no. How are you doing today? He looks back at me. That soul opens up and he says, I'm going to be honest with you. It's been a rough 5 years. Okay. Yahtzee. We are in, guys. We're in. Oh, man. Tell me about every single month of them.
I tell you, yeah, it's been rough out there, but you know, today's not been... Oh, you don't mind. You mind if I take this call? And I said, as long as you take me with you.
And if you are picturing a flip phone, you are correct.
Hello? Babe, I am pumped. I am pumped right now, babe. I also, I've never had a better second interview.
I'm like, yes, second interview.
I tell you, I don't know. They talk salary. They never talk salary. They said 75. Play my cards right, $1.25. I don't know. I can tell you this, though. The boys are getting back into hockey.
The boys are getting back into hockey, guys. No idea what this means. I think they had to get kicked out, or I definitely know those two kids beat the shit out of each other every day in an unfurnished basement that he's been hoping to redo since the housing crisis of 2008.
Because they said, I don't know, because it's like Prudential Plaza, or like sales. Well, I don't, like business, babe, business. And I'm like, does he not even know what he's interviewing for?
Twice? Am I watching a straight white middle-aged male fail upwards in real time? This is beautiful.
What's that? Okay, I'm gonna. Because I've earned it. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, babe, I will. I will when I get there. Okay. Okay.
And he hangs up. And now I'm thinking, how do I never let this man leave me? Hey, buddy, I just listened to almost all of your conversation.
That's good, because the boys are getting back.
I know, the boys are getting back into hockey. I'm with you on all of it.
Yeah, I tell you, man, it's been a good one out there for me.
Can I buy you a shot or do anything that'll keep you in my life forever?
You know what? I appreciate that, my man. And he starts to get up. It's been real nice. You know, you reached out to me. You gave me that seat. And
he starts doing that. I don't know if anybody else has a Midwestern uncle. I have a lot of them. And they rack you on the shoulders while they're walking away to, like, show you love, but also they're done with you. And so it's like,
that's all right, buddy. I appreciate that. All right. No, I mean that. You know, you didn't have to do that for me, but you did, buddy. It's like, so you can have your seat back, all right?
And I said, are you sure you can't say?
No, sorry. There's a little woman 45 minutes away in a train ride that I got to have sex on in the next 45 minutes.
And I couldn't think of anything. So as he hit the door, I just yelled, "I hope you mean your wife." And he goes, "Me too." Don't be a dick. Be manipulative. It's worth it. The boys are getting back into hockey.